Okay, so here we have an example model from the circulatory system. This is a little homemade model of a blood vessel, and it will be able to look at both connective tissue and epithelial tissue by examining this model. Several types of connective tissue and really just one type of epithelial tissue. So the inner surface of your blood vessels are lined by simple squamous epithelial cells. Those simple squamous epithelial cells are specialized for diffusion. They're really flat, and it's easy for gases to pass through them in and out of your bloodstream and bring things like oxygen to your cells and carbon dioxide away. Ends up in the bloodstream that flows through the vessel and gets moved around your body. The simple squamous epithelial cells make really nice tight junctions. So in this model, the different colors that you're seeing, green, yellow, and red, are pieces of three different simple squamous epithelial cells that have been wrapped around and stuck together to form a tube, which the tube is the blood vessel. They're stuck together with tight junctions. Though that's the seal between two cells that's leak-proof. And you can think this through pretty obviously, that you don't want your blood leaking out of your blood vessels. So tight junctions rule for this type of tissue. But let's see, what else do I want to say about this one? As we look at the model, we can also see that it is held together with this outer plastic tube. Now, your blood vessels obviously don't have an outer plastic tube around them. But what this is simulating is the connective tissue that's found around the blood vessel. And I'll talk about that in a minute. All epithelial tissues have an apical surface and a basement membrane. And this can be a little confusing sometimes because depending on whether the epithelial tissue is on the outside of the body, like your skin, or inside your body, like in a blood vessel, the orientation of those surfaces can change. So I want to show you that and make sure that everyone understands. Your skin, for example, is lined by your epidermis, which is made up of epithelial tissues that we'll talk about with the skin model. But in terms of these terminologies, every epithelial tissue has an apical or free surface. In this case, for your skin, it's the outside of your skin, and the apical surface touches the air. We call the air in this case the lumen. On the other side, inside your body, the bottom of the epithelial tissues connects to what we call the basement membrane. And there is connective tissue underneath the basement membrane, which acts sort of like glue to hold them together, the epithelial tissues and the basement membrane. So when we look at our skin, we have the apical surface facing the air and the basement membrane facing inside your body. Epithelial tissues that are inside your body are oriented a little bit differently. So we just talked about this blood vessel model. And the blood vessel model, right, made up of the simple squamous epithelial tissue, also has a basement membrane, an apical surface, and a lumen. But in this case, we take what we had with the skin and we roll it inward to make that tube that is the blood vessel. And now the basement membrane side is the outside of the blood vessel. And the apical surface is the inside of the blood vessel. The lumen is the space that the blood travels through. So in this case, here is our blood cell, right? It travels through the lumen. This is true for all of the cavities in your body. They're lined by epithelial tissues, and the inside of the cavity may be filled with air, or it may be filled with fluids, your digestive juices and food in your stomach. Those are the lumen. The surface of the epithelial tissue that touches the lumen is the apical surface, and the side that touches connective tissue is the basement membrane. I'd like to show you half of a simple squamous epithelial cell. This yellow cell can be removed from our model, and you can see that it's very flat, and it curves around to form the part of the tube that makes up this blood vessel. The blue in the middle here represents the nucleus of this particular cell, or half the nucleus. And you can see that one of the characteristics of simple squamous epithelial cells is that the nucleus bulges into the lumen. So if I put this back, it's kind of delicate. I'm going to rock it into place. Okay. Here is our lumen. My hand is going through the lumen. The nucleus bulges on the apical surface side into the lumen. That's a very characteristic look to simple squamous epithelial cells. There's also connective tissue on this model. The connective tissue that we can see on the blood vessel model includes the loose areolar connective tissue that is always found on the basement membrane side of epithelial cells. It's represented here by the clear plexiglass. The blood cell, a little worse for the wear here, that we made, is also a type of connective tissue, right? So blood is part of the fluid connective tissue. And this red blood cell has the characteristic sort of dimpled donut shape of a red blood cell, right? It has a little indent in the middle that maximizes the surface area on the membrane of the cell so that it can maximize how much oxygen it carries. And you'll notice that this model of a blood vessel is a capillary model. The capillaries are the smallest blood vessels in our bodies, and they are as wide as they need to be to fit one red blood cell through. If they were any smaller, things would clog up. If they're any bigger, they would be able to hold multiple blood cells, and then they wouldn't be capillaries. They would be one of the larger blood vessels. So the fluid connective tissue travels through the lumen, or the empty fluid-filled space. It's not empty, fluid-filled space in the lumen of our epithelial tissue that make up the blood vessel.